My talk is based on joint work with Andrey Andreevich Kalikov. And let's start from the problem. Let's consider a system of differential equations of the form 1. Here all functions are summable. Functions g and h are positive value. And functions p, q, r, and s may be complex valued. Lambda is complex spectral parameter. This equation includes eigenvalue problems for the Dirac operator and eigenvalue problem for the system of telegraph equation. In the case g equals h equals 1, and or in the case g equals h. In addition, such problems arises in studies of polynomial spectral pencils. Our goal is to obtain a symplectic behavior of fundamental solutions to the system, one, assuming minimal requirements, and then apply these asymptotics to the concrete to a concrete spectral problem. First of all, let's start from
you are going to set asymptotics in lambda, right?
Yes, asymptotics by lambda in some sector, in the half plane.
Okay,
some historical review. Initially, this some asymptotics was obtained by Schlesinger in 1907, but more general results were obtained by Tamarkin in his PhD work in Petrograd, where in as a particular case, he considered systems of the form, you can see it here. It is n by n systems with diagonal matrix AX. And it is the assumption that all functions are different. He proved the existence of the following fundamental solutions of such form. Here, EX lambda, it is the following matrix with integral of diagonal elements of AX. And he assumed that AX and BX are M times differentiable functions. And also he assumed that there is an infinite sector such that real parts of these numbers can be ordered in such way in this sector. Tamarkin's work was published only in Russian, so it became well known after it was published by parts in German and in English. Before it, in 1923, Birchow and Langer published their well-known paper with similar results. I mean, similar smoothness and similar accuracy for asymptotical representation. And last works on this theme belongs to the authors Mityagin, Jakov, Savchuk, Shkalikov, Lunyov, Malamut, and Aridaroga. In the first part of report, the key difference why we consider these asymptotics phase I will discuss later and on this slide. In the first part of report, we will obtain the asymptotics of fundamental matrix YX lambda, which satisfies the equation 2. It is the initial equations 1, but in matrix form. And we will obtain these asymptotics for each value of the parameter lambda in. They are the same, but Tamarkin considered n by n systems. But the key difference it is the smoothness of functions. They considered, and Tamarkin and Birchow and Langer considered m times differentiable functions. But we will discuss for our purposes, we need asymptotics in the case of integrable coefficients and absolutely continuous coefficients. And for these cases, we need completely another approach to obtain these asymptotics. And in the case, general case of Sobolev space N1, we also strengthen the results because we, with the same smoothness, we obtain by one more term. And of asymptotics, and this result is sharp in some sense. Here it is.
The approach is different from the approach of Tamarkin.
Yes, yes. Significantly different.
And what was done by Tamaki, what was the idea of
Tamaki? Sorry for disturbing you. No problem. He used general Dini theorem, like in Birchhoff and Langer, and he works with adjoint system of equation and used some estimation on.
He written some integral equations.
I think yes. In some sense, it is the integral equation. There is some operators, and the solution was the series of these operators. But he used more rough estimation for integrals. Okay, let's start from the obtaining of main terms of asymptotics. And we start from for the case of diagonal matrix BX. It means DX. You can see here DX, it is the diagonal from matrix BX. And in this case, in the equation 3, you can see that system disjoints, and we can obtain exact solutions. And you can see it on the bottom of the slide. It is multiplication of two matrix E at x lambda and M at x. This fundamental matrix satisfies initial condition equals to identity matrix. Okay, so we obtain exact solution for system 3. And the form of this solution suggests a substitution in general case of such form. And this convenient substitution and further reduction to the integral operators, square root of which is contraction, was proposed in the paper Savchuk-Shkalikov 2020. After this replacement, we go from the equation 2. You can see it on the top of slide. And we go to the system 5 for that. And here, A, it is the diagonal matrix as initial. And matrix Q is skew diagonal. You can see it here. And we also add some notice for gammas. It is the difference between two functions on the diagonal of A. Okay, and let's formulate main theorem. First of all, our coefficients are summable. Then there is fundamental matrix of the form. You can see it here. If we remove small o from one from this equation, it is the exact solution for diagonal system. And in general case, we get this small o from one. And small o is should be understood in the terms of L infinity. Also, the remainder small o from one can be specified more precisely in terms of integrals with variable limits. You can see.
Yes,
and this half plane is arbitrarily fixed half plane. So we can use any shift d, any real shift. Okay. Next point of the theorem, it is asymptotics in the case of absolutely continuous coefficients. In this case, we can obtain one more term of asymptotics. These coefficients, it is matrix P1 from X. You can see it here. All coefficients, Qs and gammas, explicitly expressed from coefficients of equation and has the smoothness equals to the initial coefficients of the systems. And in general case, we have next asymptotical representation in the half plane. And here we have P1 matrix as in the on the following state. And it is the base for recurrent formulas to obtain coefficients of higher order terms from recurrent formulas, which you can see below. For example, skew diagonal elements of P2(1) and P1(2) can be obtained from previous coefficients by some differential expression and integral expression, which you can see here. It means that we differentiate and integrate these coefficients. And some remark. First of all, smoothness of P1(2) and P2(1) from this has the smoothness coincides with the smoothness of the coefficients in the equation 1. That it means that they are in WN1, and the recurrence formulas shows, due to taking of derivative, that nth term of asymptotics near lambda in the power minus n, it is absolutely continuous functions. And in the general case, next coefficients are only summable. So obtained result is sharp in that sense, because we want to find a classic solution y and asymptotic representation for them. Okay, the next part of the talk, it is the spectral problem for which I will use these asymptotic formulas. Here we add boundary conditions 7, and all functions are absolutely continuous. Also, boundary conditions have a very simple form. They turn out to be non-regular, and we will see it from the form of the characteristic determinant. Substituting the asymptotics proved in the theorem for absolutely continuous case into characteristic determinant, we can obtain following form of the characteristic determinant on the top of the slide. And in the regular case, instead of lambda in the power minus 2, we should obtain non-zero constant plus big O from lambda in the minus 1. But so it is non-regular case. And applying Crochet theorems, we can come from delta from lambda to delta 0 from lambda in the sense that zeros of delta 0 from lambda asymptotically coincide up to small o from 1 with zeros of this new quasi-polynomial.
Why the term with large o of lambda to the power minus 1 that doesn't contribute?
The first term is of order 1, 1, the second is of order 1 over lambda, the third is 1 over lambda squared. Lambda is large, right? Yes. And so the term of order 1 over lambda has to be important. It is not, I think it is due to exponential.
And A0 and B0 can be positive and negative.
Okay, A0 and B0, it is positive constants.
Positive constants. But then the second, this term is 1 over lambda squared, is exponentially small, isn't it, in lambda?
Yes, I think so.
And why then the term is 1 over lambda, that doesn't contribute to the asymptotics?
It depends on what you want to state. So you want to say that you have is delta 0 and then what?
Okay, this term is 1 over lambda. It depends on what it depends, yeah.
But what do you want to state?
I want to find the asymptotics for eigenvalues of the problem.
So what is your answer? So you should we should find this delta 0 and...
We should find the... zeros of delta 0 out from lambda, zeros of this quasi-polynomial, and from it we get asymptotics for the zeros of delta lambda.
And when you say asymptotics, up to which
up to o with minus 1. Up to small o from 1. I think I need to think a bit later on this point. Да, yes. And the I will check it, and the hopeful results it is the asymptotics for the asymptotics of such quasi polynomials is well known, and it is like on the bottom formal, and small o from one it is it goes from the applying Roche's theorem, and the final statement it is the that also the problem is non-regular. Completeness of agent-associated functions can be proved by standard method for regular problems after some modification, and so we have completeness of the spectral of agent and associated functions of the spectral problem 6-7 in this space and the assumptions of the theorem 2 and the assumption of this theorem.